Then moderator, Sweta Sultania, Vice President, Transaction Advisory Services from Ernst & Young. Mr. Shishan Banerjee, AVP, Tata Cleantech. Mr. Brajesh Kumar Sinha, Vice President, Business Development from Fourth Partner Energy. Mr. Piyush Bhatheja, AVP, Business Development, Statkraft BLP. Mr. Gambhir Balyan, from Everest Solar. Mr. Alok Verma, AVP, Policy and Regulatory Affairs, Amplus Solar. Mr. Anil Sudhakar, Regional Head, Sales and Marketing, Rely on Solar. Mr. Bhuwan Singh Panwar, Regional Manager, West, Jinko Solar. And Mr. Dheeraj Anand, Head of Business Development, West India at Cleanmax. Kindly come forward and take your seats on the dais so we can begin our next session on developers and financing. And we are happy to have Mr. Bhuwan, who is also, who's representing Jinko, which is the world's largest module company. So definitely module as one of the key component and the most important ingredient in the project. He'll be enlightening us about its technology and the product roadmaps and the pricing roadmaps. The session format will be around 5 to 7 minutes of independent speech or presentation by each panelist, and will be a panel discussion conducted by the session moderator, Sweta Sultania.
I am Sweta Sultania from Ernst & Young. I am from the Transaction Advisory Services team. We do a lot of work on the renewable power side, including wind as well as solar. And we do a lot of financing, equity as well as debt, as well as mergers and acquisitions. I'll request all the panelists to kindly introduce themselves.
Good morning, everybody. My name is Piyush Bhatheja. I represent a company called Statkraft BLP Solar Solutions. We have offices in Bangalore and Delhi, and we are a joint venture between Statkraft, which is a Norwegian state-owned utility, and India's Bharat Light and Power, BLP.
Thanks. Hello, everyone. My name is Sirsanath Banerjee. I am from Tata Cleantech Capital Limited. This is a joint venture between Tata Capital and IFC Washington, and we'll get to know more about it as and when we progress.
Good morning, everyone. This is Anil Surarkar from Rely on Solar Private Limited. The company is based out of Pune, and we are operating almost in 18 states of the country. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Bhuwan Singh Panwar, and I am representing Jinko Solar here. We are world number one in solar module manufacturing with a global capacity of 7 gigawatt as of now, and with a cell capacity of 4 gigawatts. And I'm responsible for western and southern region of India. And I mean, we can discuss more about the modules and prices when it comes to the discussion session.
So good afternoon, gentlemen. I'm Alok Verma from Amplus Energy. I look after policy and regulatory affairs for Amplus. And Amplus essentially a rooftop, a distributed solar power developer, primarily working with the commercial and industrial consumer across the India. And currently we own the largest portfolio with these consumer, around 200 megawatt of a capacity, and many in the pipelines. So we also have a big plans for the Gujarat, but due to some, there are certain gaps in the policy and the regulatory environment. So we are also working with the authorities here and trying to push for a favorable environment here. So we hope to see our presence in Gujarat very soon. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Dheeraj Anand, representing Cleanmaxsolar. We are based out of Mumbai and have offices in the north in Delhi, NCR. We've got an office in the south in Bangalore, and we've recently started up our operations in the Middle East, UAE to be specific. We are basically solar developers catering to the CNI sector, and also expanding our presence in down south with a solar park in Karnataka. Thank you.
Yeah, good afternoon. My name is Gambhir Balyan. I am representing Everest Industries Limited, which is a roofing solution provider company, recently entered into a new entity in a solar business. We are new startup. We are just starting the each and every operations and developing our departments.
Thank you, gentlemen. And I would also like to thank EQ, a big round of thank you to them for organizing this. And you know, normally we do a lot of conferences. I have done in Delhi, Mumbai, Bangalore, etc. So this is my first conference that I'm attending in Ahmedabad, and it is a privilege to do so. You know, before I invite the panelists, you know, for you know, their you know, presentations, what you know, we, you know, just to give you a sense of you know, where the market, how the investors and the financiers are looking at the renewable sector, especially solar, is that today the way the, you know, bids have been taking place on the utility scale side, and most of you will be familiar with, you know, how the returns have been because of various reasons. Today we are finding increasingly that many of the larger IPP players are actually focusing their attention on the rooftop solar scale. There are several names, you know, when we get to the discussions, there are niche players which have, you know, which focus entirely on this sector. Especially, you know, there are, you know, leading companies in this like Amplus, like Cleanmax, and we have people from there. Along with them, there are the larger IPPs, which were otherwise utility scale. They have also identified this as a, you know, niche sector which offers better returns per project. Although it's a little slow, in small in terms of scaling up, which remains a challenge, but there are very fundamental levers which are actually supporting and encouraging rooftop solar. Commercials and industrials is a no-brainer. Even for residentials, especially in states and cities where the tariffs are very high, this is, there are fundamental levers why people should look at rooftop solar. In fact, I remember a discussion with a French company that I was meeting way back in 2007. That gentleman actually told me 10 years ago, it's a no-brainer for people in Europe to have rooftop solar. And probably we are at a time today when increasingly, especially in Mumbai, you know, we come across, I think every day now, news that some societies are, you know, setting up rooftop solar. And this reduces the load on the grid. And this, it commercially, it is viable, as well as societies feel better about contributing to the environment causes. Having said that, I will like to invite the first panelist, Mr. Dheeraj of Cleanmaxsolar.
Who we are, what we do, and you know, our journey thus far. Thank you. So, you know, we claim to be one of India's largest rooftop developers with over 85 megawatt capacity and a 24% market share. Our business model is basically where we just seek the roof or the spare ground available with our industrial partners and provide them an option of relatively cheaper source of power and at no investment to them at all. We enter into a long-term power purchase agreement and through that recover the investments. We've got presence with some of the leading multinational companies operating in the country, as well as you know, some local Indian manufacturing companies as well. To name a few, we've got Asahi Glass, we've got General Electric, we've got the Mahindra Group, and Tata Motors, Thyssen Group, so on and so forth. The reason for us being so successful is because of the you know, flexibility that we offer in our power purchase agreements. You know, be the convenience at the end of the day is what the customer is looking for, and we are out there to address any concern that they would have. And we've typically seen that, you know, it's the provision for termination which becomes a challenge, you know, whether they want to get the solar power plant or, you know, they want us to take it back or take it out or move the power plant in case they move their manufacturing setup. So that kind of flexibilities is what, you know, we've been able to bring as a value add on the table. we've been into this business since the year 2010-11, and this was started by stalwarts in the industry, and they come from various experienced manufacturing companies like Thermax, Mahindra Solar, Bridge to India, and myself, I'm coming from a German company called Linde. As I was mentioning, this is a Bridge to India report for the year 2017. We've been number one with a 24% market share, and the number two, number three is never been a single figure. We've been able to maintain the number one position over the last 3 years, and number two, number three has always been a different developer, so to say. We've been recognized by MNRE. Here you can see our managing director, Mr. Kuldeep Jain, on the left, and our chief operating officer, Mr. Umakant Shende, on the right, receiving the awards from MNRE. These are our privileged customers. We've got, take a name and it's out there. We've reached out to various manufacturing industries across various sectors, so to say. Since we are developers, we invest in the solar plant. So in order to make sure that we continue to grow our business, we've recently got lines or investment from Warburg Pincus to the tune of almost $1 million US dollars, and which we are utilizing to grow our business in the rooftop segment. And also, of course, with the solar farms that is being developed in the state of Karnataka for now. As I said, we've got a pan-India presence, Mumbai, Pune, Bangalore, NCR, Chennai, and recently, in the Middle East, UAE to be specific. This is our leadership team. All of them are professionals. Kuldeep is an ex-partner from McKinsey. I am Ahmedabad graduate, chartered accountant, and the likes of Gajanan Nabar, who was with Praj Industries as well as with Praxair India before joining Cleanmax. So as I was mentioning about, our business model, it's zero capex basically for any industry who wants to adapt solar. It takes away the investment risks, it takes away the management bandwidth, in order to, that would normally be taken into account if one is investing in their own solar plant. So we just take away all of that. All you need to do is pay a monthly bill that is lower, significantly lower than what you pay to the grid for the number of units that you consume through the solar plant. This is what I was just mentioning about. Not to forget about the sustainability and the green initiative that it would bring onto a manufacturing industry. We also build up the smart working systems. It's remotely monitored. It can give you a real time data about how the solar plant is performing. And this would be at no additional cost, So we take care of everything that goes into a solar plant. Safety, which is paramount here, in working on rooftops, is also taken care of, by the procedures and the learnings that we've had from our experience with this in this business. You can see that we've got a safety line attached to the person. This is a schematic representation of that, and a real-time picture of a monkey ladder with a cage in order to prevent any mishaps. I've just briefly told you about the business model. We'll, as developers, would be responsible for the entire EPC of the project. We will operate and maintain the project, the plant, and we'll supply the energy at a mutually agreed tariff. All you need to do is just allow us to utilize your roof or spare land available and access to your facility for O&M purposes and some water for the cleaning of the solar panel. So that is basically what we expect from our customers. I have certain technical annexures about the equipment that goes into a solar plant. I'll pass for now in the interest of time. We can take these questions offline, but this is just to show you we deal with tier one suppliers globally. This is basically the remote monitoring system that we have, and the data logging systems. I'll just briefly cover some pictures, real-time pictures of our projects. This is the General Electric plant in Pune, where we have a non-penetrating structure, so this prevents any damage to the roof or any water ingress that is the normal risk that people have. This is the Asahi glass plant in Chennai, the Mahindra Nasik plant one, where we've developed this carport structure for them. This is the Bangalore International Airport. This is Tata Motors Sanand, which is about 30 kilometers away. And this is the Manipal University in Jaipur. NBC Bearings here in Gujarat. And that's about it. Thank you. And I'll be happy to take questions as we progress further.
Thank you, Dheeraj. That was a very informative session. I omitted to mention that at the end of all the sessions, we will certainly be open for Q&A. So please have patience and wait till then. I would now like to request Mr. Bhuwan Singh Pawar from Jinko Solar to kindly address the audience.
Hi, good afternoon. I'm not sharing any presentation with you because, I just want to go ahead and we have a very limited time here, like 7 minutes to go ahead with. So I'll just take you through how Jinko is and how we are placed up in a global scenario. With a global number one tag with us with 6.7 gigawatt of facility we have. We have already done some 22 gigawatts across the world, and in India we have already supplied around 800 megawatts this year. Looking at rooftop, especially at rooftop scenario in India, we have decided to come up with a legal identity in India, and now we are very much there as Jinko Trading Company India, with a fantastic team of around 20 people with all post-sales and pre-sales support, which generally we don't used to see from any of the international customers. International suppliers. So we have that in presence. So whatever we have, we are trying to support up with. Generally, what happens is when we supply modules, there were many questions and there were many complaints coming up that, okay, when we have some issues coming up with the modules or any of the modules, the support time is very large. It takes sometime 1 month, 1.5, 2 months. So to reduce that, we have these kind of teams set up with us. So for rooftop plants in India, we already came up with godowns. So it is not like we are shipping directly through China and it'll take 1.5 month or 2 months to reach and close all everything. So we have our godowns. We have one in Delhi, a second upcoming in Mumbai. Third one we are planning in Bangalore. So we are increasing our footprints in India. Opening up offices, one we have in Delhi now. It's a full-fledged office with legal staff. Your entire technical team, sales team. We have one in Mumbai, another one coming up in Bangalore. So here, let's talk about the products we are offering in rooftop. So in rooftop segment, we came up with some advanced product like half-cut sails and smart modules, which we will be introducing within 1 month's time in India. With half-cut sail modules, you will be getting at least 10 watt peak more than a normal module within a 72 sail size, which we are talking. With the same weight, same size, if you're getting 10 watt peak more with a half cut technology, that will create a difference when you go for a rooftop.
And with smart module, these are a unique kind of modules we are promoting in. It's having an MPPT control on string level. So what will happen if you have a shadow effect coming up? So what we have seen, if there is a shadow on a module, like if there is a shadow on 3 or 4 cell, it will kill the entire string. So now with these modules, the 3 or 4 cell will be isolated automatically. You'll not have the hotspot on the module, and your rest of the module will work. So this will give you give an advanced level of installation, which you can do in the rooftop segment where there is a shadow effect. There are many good places which we are leaving. Even I come from a background of EPC. I have seen many places which is fantastic roof. We have a lot of roof available, but there is a small shadow effect because of which we are not able to cover the entire lot. With this kind of setups, we can definitely kill those areas and go up with installation and try to figure out what best we can do on these kind of roofs. Being the biggest supplier from China, the one big question always comes in picture. How do you see anti-dumping coming in? Everyone will be asking that. So, I mean, anti-dumping is very much on the table. We are listening to it. But yes, I mean, including all partners across the India, all developers around with us, we are trying to see how we can work on that. And there is another big issue which came in was a custom duty of 7.5%, which we all are facing right now. It's a killing factor in the industry because there are a lot many containers which I have seen were lying on the ports and all. So for this, I just want to give an update. There is already a petition which had been filed, and I hope within next month's time this will be over. So we'll be coming out of this big issue in India. So, I mean, that's all from my side. I'm not taking much of time here. Thank you. Just let me know if there is any question on rooftop side or any question on technology side. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Mr. Pawar. In fact, that was going to be one of my questions for the last session about the anti-dumping duty, especially because, you know, it affects, you know, Chinese companies significantly. I would now like to invite the next panelist, Mr. Anil Suryacon from Railon Solar Private Limited.
Good afternoon, everyone. Yesterday, while coming to Ahmedabad, there was a rain which has started. And one of my friend that said to me that, is it a winter season or it's a rainy season? I am a little bit confused. I said it's an impact of global warming. So here I would like to say that every one of us is contributing, those who are working in solar industry, for coming out of this global warming session. So for that, I think we should have a round of applause for everyone. Okay, to start with my session, I am from Reliance Solar Private Limited, a Pune company, Pune-based company, wherein in any of the solar power plant, there are certain key factors which contributes a lot. First of all, the material and component selection, the plant design, workmanship, and operation and maintenance. These are the four important aspects of any of the solar system. When everybody says to the client that the life of the solar panel is 25 years, the customer's point of view, that he say that what's big deal, if you are also saying the same thing what other players are saying. So it's really difficult to say that our company is a 7 to 8 years old company and we are talking about 25 years of life. Even that would be a very difficult situation for many of the people here, those who are recently started their operations in a year or two. So how do we say that we can give you a better quality panels or better quality modules? So in that particular case, that we definitely would like to share this particular aspect that these are the, if you see this particular picture, you will see that there are certain micro cracks into that. Whenever we select any of the panel from any of the panel manufacturer, we generally go for rigorous testing. And once we go with this testing, then only we procure this particular material. So this is the one which we had rejected, and if you see this picture, you will not find any micro cracks in this. So this is the main crux of Reliance Solar. We believe that whatever the panel which are going on the rooftops or on the ground mounted systems, these all are panels which has been verified by our technical team, because the company has started by Dr. Sabde, who had owning 29 patents in his name in this particular field. We operate in different kind of rooftops, like metal sheet. You see, this is the optimum angle which has been maintained in this particular picture. The metal sheet wherein the natural slope is being taken into consideration, and we have installed the solar system into that. The RCC floor, again, the optimum angle is been maintained in this. And there are certain installations which are not obtaining the space, but we are creating the space. So every installation which we have installed has got some story. I would like to elaborate something about this particular picture. This particular customer is an IT company in Pune, wherein they are looking for an solar installation, but they say that they don't have this space. When we had gone and checked with them, we found that there is no space. And the municipal corporation, they were not allowing them to build any of the additional roof and then put the solar panel. So we said to them that you need not to worry about that. We'll create a space for you. And we came up with this design, and they liked this design. And because of this particular design, we also got a repeat order after 3 years. So definitely you can understand that any customer who is giving a repeat order to the company, definitely he is satisfied, we can say. Other than that, this is the flexible panel which we have installed on the railway. It's a railway coach. Then some of the innovative solutions we have, wherein we have used BIPV panel and the solar rooftop as a car park. What we see that every roof is a unique, and every customer's requirement is different. So based on customer's requirement, we go and do a study and then give the solutions. There are a couple of case studies, but I'll not go in each and every case study which has been mentioned over here. I'll just quickly go through some of the case studies which has been very useful, particularly to the client who is having a limited space. There is a commercial mall in Pune wherein you can see this particular picture, wherein instead of going for 18 degree, we have gone for 5 degree angle only. Yes, there is a generation drop for the client, and we have communicated to the client that if we obtained 18 degree angle over here, we can install only 300 kilowatt system, and by that if we maintain 5 degree of the angle, then we can install 565 kilowatt solar system. But by doing this, instead of saving 48 lakh rupees in 300 kilowatt, you can save 87 lakh rupees. So what's your take? What you would like to go for? Definitely, customer said that since the unit rate was 14 rupees to 15 rupees for the client, he said that I would like to go for 565 kilowatt, even though there are certain generation drop into that. Apart from that, there are certain areas, like this is another case study wherein the rooftop was very complex. Too many water tanks was there, columns were there, and design for a structural engineer to do that was very complicated. So taking into consideration of all, we have increased the capacity, taking and from 30 kilowatt we have installed 100 kilowatt for that particular area. So you can see that we have utilized all the tanks, and we have elevated the structure over here. Other than that, there are certain like more case studies wherein 17 buildings were there, multiple evacuation. This is one of the innovative again design which we have installed in Maharashtra. This is one of the area I would like to share a few seconds. We have developed the trackers. Those who are working in ground-mounted solar system, definitely you can look at to the, or we can have a more discussion on this particular aspect. With this particular tracker, you can increase your efficiency by 17% to 25%. This is the indigenous tracker which has been developed by Reliance Solar. And you can say that you need not to do a levelized ground for this installation of tracker. Even though the land is uneven, in that case also we can have this particular tracker installed. If you have any queries or question, we can have it later on. Thank you EQ.
Thank you very much, Anil. That was a very helpful session.